7 days later, and our bacon, and we can call it bacon at this point because the pork bellies have now cured in that salt sugar mixture. And over the course of 7 days, every day I would just kind of flip it over. And that's just to make sure that all this moisture that's inside the bag, that came out of the pork. So that's all the water that was pushed out of the cells by the salt. And you want to make sure that this cure gets all over. And so that's every day flipping and making sure that that you're moving the moisture around and moving the liquid around. This is cured bacon, essentially. And I'm going to take it a step farther and smoke it, but you don't have to. So you could, at this point, do the same as I'm going to do here. Pull it out of the brine and give it a good rinse under a tap. Cold water, just to wash all of that brine and sugar and salt off the outside of the pork, or bacon at this point. And if you're not going to smoke it, you can go ahead and cut the skin off the outside, portion it into meal-sized portions, and then seal it and freeze it. Even though it's cured, you still have to refrigerate this, and it's only going to last so long in your refrigerator. So it's best to freeze what you're not going to use right away, and cook it just like you would cook bacon from the supermarket. But because I'm going to smoke it, I'm going to rinse all of the pieces just like I've rinsed this one. I'm going to place them on a rack, and then I'm going to put this in the fridge for 12 to 24 hours. In my case, probably 24 hours. What you want to do is have it dry out, and something called a pellicule, which is a French word for skin or film or small skin, is going to form on the outside. And this just helps it when you take it to the next step and smoke it. It's something for the smoke to stick to, and it really improves your flavor in the end. So I'm just going to rinse the rest of these, throw them back in the fridge, and then tomorrow we're going to smoke them.